Hey there, it's May, which means that we are in the middle of the fifth month of the Language Reading Challenge, and we're getting ready to start the sixth month. And I realized that I hadn't yet introduced the Language Reading Challenge here on YouTube, so I just wanted to do a quick introduction and invite you to join us. So what is the Language Reading Challenge? The Language Reading Challenge is a monthly link up where we read books that are related to the languages that we're learning. And even though we're almost starting our sixth month, it is not too late for you to join in, and we'd absolutely love to have you join us. So far we've covered month one, a book about the culture of the language that you're studying. Month two, a book in your target language. Three, a travelogue or a book about traveling to the country that speaks your language. Four, a book about language. And this month's five, is to finish or start a course book that you've been working through. This coming month, June, month six, is to read a book written by a language blogger. And there might just be a certain language blogger you know who happens to have a book that has recently been released. So if you're not sure where to start, I do have a book out called Say Goodbye to Shy, Speaking a Language the Introvert's Way, which was published by Fluent in 3 months. So I'll include a link to that below. But there are a ton of books written by other language bloggers, which are fantastic. So you should definitely check out the works of bloggers like Kirsten Cable Hannes, Benny Lewis, Ollie Richards, and there are just so many more. And I'm sorry for those of you that I didn't name, but a quick look on Amazon will show you tons of language bloggers who have books out. After this month, the books that we're going to read, month seven, a history of the region that speaks your language. It can be a country, it could be a specific state or province. If you are learning a dialect or a minority language, you can read about the areas that those are tied to. Month eight, we're going to read about the history of a language. Month nine, we're going to read another book in our target languages. Month 10, we're going to read a book on learning strategies, not just language learning, but learning in general. Month 11, we're going to read a book set in a country that speaks your language. It could be fiction or nonfiction. And finally, month 12, we're going to read a comic book in your target language. So to answer a few questions that I've had about the challenge so far, if you're more advanced in your target language, you can feel free to read any of these books in your target language, not just the two that are actually supposed to be in your target language. So you can read a book on the history of the language, a travelogue in your target language. So that's totally open, but you can read them in your native language as well. You don't have to pick just one language for the challenge. So if you're studying more than one language, you can alternate between them. And to complete the challenge, you're welcome to read books of any level. So you can read graded readers or children's books or anything even advanced to fulfill the requirements. And you don't even need to finish the book to qualify for the challenge. If you don't finish the book that you're reading within the month, you can still share your thoughts as a part of the link up. That's totally fine. You don't have to participate every single month of the challenge. You can just choose to participate the months that align with your interests. And that's it for now. So I'll include a link in the box below with more information on the Language Reading Challenge. I hope you'll join us. It's been a lot of fun so far, and it would be really interesting to learn a bit about what you're reading. If you have any other questions that I didn't answer as a part of this video, feel free to hit me up in the comments below, and I look forward to hearing from you. Thank you for watching.